They wanted to come here and put on a little mini show for you guys, and you guys signed up and decided to come here. So thank you so much for coming out here. And because they're the Beatles interactive experience, I'm going to do my best possible impersonation if I can. Okay, Ed Sullivan, here it is. Oh, right here on the show. I don't know why he's British. Hold on. Right here on the show today, we have a very... give it up for them all the way from over from the pond in Omaha, Nebraska. Here they are, Yesterday and Today. Give a nice round of applause.
Thank you for that rousing intro.
Wow.
I'm British Ed Sullivan, you know. You know, it's great, love them, you know. Hi, everybody. How are we doing? I'm Billy McGuigan. This is my brother Ryan McGuigan, and that's Matthew McGuigan. We'll tell you about why we love Beatles music after we play a few songs and prove ourselves to the guys that are going, why are they not dressed like the Beatles? Because
like
I'm Beatles. Talking like Ed Sullivan now, you know. I've just seen a face, I can't forget the time or place that we first met. She's just the girl for me, and I want all the world to see we've met. Die. Had it been another day, I might have looked the other way, and I'd have never been aware. As it is, I'll dream of her tonight. Die. Falling, yes, I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Yes, I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Hey! I've just seen her face, I can't forget the time or place that we first met. She's just the girl for me, I want all the world to see we've met. Falling, yes, I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Oh, well, I'm falling, yes, I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Oh, well, I'm falling, yes, I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Thank you. Try to see in my way. Do I have to keep on talking till I can go on? Why to see it your way? Run the risk of knowing that our love may soon be gone. We can work it out. We can work it out. Think of what you're saying. We can get it wrong and still you think that it's alright. Think of what I'm saying. We can work it out and get it straight or say goodnight. We can work it out. We can work it out. And life is very short. And there's no time for fussing and fighting, my friend. I have always thought that it's a crime. So I will ask you once again. Try to see it my way. Only time will tell if I am right or I am wrong. Why to see it your way? There's a chance that we might fall apart before too long. We can work it out. We can work it out. And life is very short. And there's no time for fussing and fussing and fighting, my friend. I have always thought that it's a crime. So why? Try to see it my way. Only time will tell if I am right or I am wrong. Why to see it your way? There's a chance that we might fall apart before too long. We can work it out. We can work it out. Thank you. This is one of the very first songs that we learned. I was probably 7 years old. Ryan was 4. Matthew was 1. He didn't really participate that much back then.
No.
He was still in diapers. That was pretty much his participation.
I still am in diapers.
You guys didn't need to know that, but it is true. He's never grown out of it. How old are you now?
Old enough.
Cool. Okay. Still not potty trained. Congratulations. It's great to be here. Looking at Elvis up here. It's a pretty cool atrium. We got Stevie Nicks and Keith and Mick and Ray Charles and Cher. No Beatles, so. All right, calm down, you guys. All right, I can't see that part. No, they're right over here! All right.
That boy took my love away. Though he'll regret it someday, this boy wants you back again. That boy isn't good for you, though he may want you to. Wants you back again. Oh, just a this boy wouldn't mind the pain, would always feel the same, till this boy gets you back again. This boy, this boy, this boy.
Thank you. Super exciting to see you not do that in diapers, buddy. Well done.
No, I'm still in
diapers. So a lot of people often wonder what makes our show different yesterday and today. And the first thing is that when we do the show, it's kind of like this. We don't dress up like the Beatles. We're not trying to be the Beatles. Who can attempt to be the Beatles? Certainly not us. We are just huge Beatles fans, and we've dedicated most of our lives to learning every song in the Beatles catalog and being able to perform them at the drop of a hat. Now, that's not to say we don't mess up. We do. And we're very proud of that fact. Just because it's easy to mess up doing that. But we started, our dad was in the Air Force, and we traveled all over the country and the world. And he was a military guy, and he was a tech sergeant in the Air Force, so we didn't have much money growing up. So he, instead of taking us out to go to nice places, what he would call Shoney's.
Red Lobster.
Not if they're a sponsor, but if they are, we couldn't afford to go to your place. I know. And then there was the unattainable goal for our family, which was Red Lobster. We still haven't eaten there. It's a 5-star restaurant in our family. So instead of going to do those things, we would stay at home, and our dad would get out a Beatle chord book that you can now fit in an iPad. And we would just sit around, and he taught us all these songs, and that's how we learned them and fell in love with them. And when Matthew was born, he was born in Germany. And for 4 years of our lives, we didn't have television because we lived off base. It was all in German. All I remember is the Fall Guy in German. The Fall Guy und Vera! So we didn't watch that. So instead, we listened to Beatles records, did this. And we lost our dad at a very early age. He died when he was just 42 from leukemia. And this music is what we turned to and fell in love with. And so our show
we let the audience pick, right? We want to know your name, we want to know your favorite Beatles song, and most importantly, we want to know why you chose that song. So that's how our show works. It's kind of different, it's kind of cool. So if you have requests, you can think of them. We'll take, we already have one. All right, we'll give you a line of a Beatles song. What do you got for me?
Don't pass me by.
Oh. Win C or G?
C.
C. I love this one.
Listen for your footsteps coming up the drive. Listen for your footsteps, but they don't arrive. Said that you would be late about an hour or two. I don't see you. Does it mean you don't love me anymore?
Let's take it to the chorus. Everybody.
Don't pass me by. Don't make me cry. Don't make me blue. Well, you know, darling, I love only you. You'll never know it hurt me so. I'll hate to see you go. Don't pass me by. Don't make me cry. Don't make me blue.
All right, I have to sing this line because it's the weirdest line in any Beatles song. And I'm so glad Ringo wrote it. This verse.
Sorry that I doubted you. That was so unfair. You were in a car crash and you lost your hair.
What? How did they let that one slide through?
Ringo's like, I've got a great idea for a song. You were in a car crash and for some weird reason you lost your hair.
My son is 11. He loves the Beatles, and he would ask me the question. He would just, he listens to that song, and he's, he goes, drugs, Dad? And I would go, yeah. It's pretty safe to say that song was drug-induced. In fact, let's sing it. You know, thank you for, why do you love Don't Pass Me By? You thought you were going to stump us with one?
No.
Okay. Look at the joy in his face. That's why we do this show, man. It's like, that's why. Yeah. He's like, don't pass me by. I love Ringo, and I love the song. And clearly, I've lost my hair, and I get it. Sir, what happened to your hair?
Car crash.
It was in a fender bender. It was ugly. So, I'm supposed to be promoting our show. Look at, everybody's excited now. They're like, we get to yell a Beatles song and they'll play it? Pretty much, yeah. Anybody else want to just yell? Oh, here we go. That's a... Oh, we're sticking with Ringo. All right.
I'd like to be under the sea in an octopus's garden in the shade. He'd let us in, knows where we've been in his octopus's garden in the shade. I'd ask my friends to come and see an octopus's garden with me.
Everybody!
I'd like to be under the sea in an octopus's garden in the shade.
Now, one thing our dad did teach us in this song was how to do the underwater singing that they do in the so. Ready? Two, yep. Three, four.
We would shout and sing about the coral.
That's all I got. I mean, that's pretty good. The underwater singing, I love. And my son also told me that the line, the coral that lies beneath, he says, if you say it like Rick from The Walking Dead, if you say the coral that lies beneath the waves.
Coral.
Got a lot of Ringo fans here. If you haven't seen Ringo live, you should definitely go do that. It's a great show. I'm not sure why I'm promoting his show, but he's the greatest. And that other dude that was in the Beatles, the same one that let the car crash line get through, he's playing at the stadium next to us. So
you should go see him too.
These guys have tickets. Do you have tickets? Have you seen him yet? Oh, man. I have a quick story to tell you about seeing Paul. I've seen Paul live 12 times. It's awesome. If you get the chance to breathe the same air as a Beatle, and I see a Paul McCartney tour shirt, so he saw it too. So I saw McCartney about the sixth time I went to Dallas to see him. George Martin was at the show. I saw George Martin. I'm like, oh, my God. And so I knew when the lights would go down. That was a good radio line there. You guys can chime in at any time. Yeah. So you go to see a concert enough, you know when the lights go out before the encore, you can make your move. I went alone, right? So the lights go down for the encore, and I ran to the front, past security. I'm just running to the front. The lights came up, and he was 3 feet in front of me, right? And he just starts going. He's like, yesterday, and I could see all the fillings in his teeth. I was like,
gross.
That, I know. That's my first Paul McCartney yesterday story. The seventh time I saw him, I got seats in the seventh row because I thought mortgaging your house when you have a three-year-old child is a smart idea just so you can see a Beatle. I knew that he did this bits about signs on this tour, and he was like, yeah, you know, I look at all the signs, you know, and it's distracting, you know, because I'm reading the signs. And I had a sign made that said, name my daughter Cartney after Sir Paul, right? I have a three-year-old, she's three, she's turned 16 now. And I'm holding the sign up, and I hold it up, and I'm like, Paul, look, that's what a normal person would do. And for some reason, he saw it as I'm screaming, and I'm like shaking, and he covered his eyes, and he pointed to the sign, and I, like everything froze. My heart stopped beating, my eyelids stopped doing whatever they do, fingernails stopped growing, everything stopped. My hero is looking at something I wrote, and he reads it, and then he pointed at me and gave me a thumbs up, and I peed my pants.
And that's why I wear diapers still, just in case.
We're the McGuigan brothers with loose bladders, evidently. And so now I have the sign framed, name my daughter Cartney after Sir Paul, and right next to it also framed are those pants.
My baby don't care.
baby don't care. My baby don't care. My baby don't. Thank you.
Good. Thank you. Thank you. Did anybody think of any requests while we were? Yes. Help! I don't think I've heard. Do you know? Have you ever heard of?
We've heard ouch.
Ouch! Ouch! Breaking my heart! Ouch! No Ruddles fans out there? Cool.
All right.
We were lucky enough in our travels of doing this show that we met Mei Pang, who was with John for a brief period of his life in the 70s. And she told us after we played the song that this is the one song that John always wanted to re-record. It was his favorite Beatles song. And we were like, oh, you could be lying, but we don't care. Ready?
Yeah. One, two, three, four. Help, I need somebody. Help, not just anybody. Help, you know I need someone. Help, when I was young, so much younger than today.
I never needed anybody's help in any way.
Now these days are gone, I'm not so selfish. Yo.
I know that I just need you like I've never done before.
Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. And I do appreciate you being around.
Help me get my feet back on the ground. Won't you please, please help me?
Now my life is changing in so many ways.
My independence seems to vanish in the haze.
But every now and then I feel so insecure.
I know that I just need you like I've never done before.
Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. And I do appreciate you being round.
Help me get my feet back on the ground. Won't you please, please help me?
When I was younger, so much younger than today, I never needed anybody's help in any way.
Now these days are gone, I'm not so selfish.
Yo.
And now I finally changed my mind. I've opened up the door.
Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. And I do appreciate you being around.
Help me get my feet back on the ground. Won't you please, please help me? Help me, help me.
Thank you. This is like our Unplugged album, you guys. This is so cool. We hope you guys are enjoying it as much as we are. We are playing at the Menominee Nation Arena tomorrow night, 7:30. Full band, of course. We're just the ones who came early.
Yep.
Because we love Wisconsin. It's great to be here with you. How about a hand for my brother, Ryan McGuigan, here? He's been working on this ponytail thing, so give him a lot of love for that.
You got to see it tomorrow.
No, you're seeing it right now. It's not going to change much. And, of course, my brother Matthew over there.
Thank you.
Matthew, can I make a request of you? You know what song I'm going to request of you to play.
Drift Away.
Yeah. Can you do one of your original? No.
I got you.
Yeah.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life, you were only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see. All your life, you were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. Into the light of the dark black night. Blackbird, fly. Black. into the light of the dark black night. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life, you were only waiting for this moment to rise. You were only waiting for this moment to rise, yeah. You were only waiting for this moment to rise.
It's Matthew McGuigan right there.
Thank you.
And that was us on the birds. Thank you. No. Okay, so we don't have much time left, so we'll do some rapid-fire Beatle requests. If you just want to yell some stuff out, we'll give you just a snippet of everything. You can even stump us. Obladi, Oblada. Desmond has a barrow in the marketplace. Molly is the single in a band. Desmond says to Molly, girl, I like your face. And Molly says this as she takes him by the hand. Next. Your blues. Oh, yeah. Yes, I'm lonely.
Wanna die. Yes, I'm lonely. Wanna die. If I ain't dead already.
Girl, you know the reason why.
Next. Her Majesty.
Her Majesty's a pretty nice girl, but she doesn't have a lot to say. Her Majesty's a pretty nice girl, but she changed from day to day.
Next.
Here I stand, head in hand, turn my face to the wall.
We gotta get to the bridge.
If she chorus gone, I can go on, feeling 2 foot small.
Everybody.
You've got to hide your love away. Hey, you've got to hide your love away.
Recorder. Next. I want to hold your hand.
Oh yeah, I'll tell you something. I think you'll understand when I say that something. I wanna hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand.
Next. Oh, yeah.
Don't let me down. Don't let me down.
Keep going, boy.
I guess nobody loved me like she do. Ooh, she do. Yes, she does. And if somebody ever really do me, ooh, she do me. Yes, she does.
Next. What's that? Eleanor Rigby. 2, 3, 4.
I look at all the lonely people. I look at all the lonely people.
Perfect.
Eleanor.
You guys are not a very good string quartet. We should try it again. Ready?
I look at all the lonely people. Do, do, do.
There it is.
I look at all the lonely people.
Oh, man, they're really good now.
What are you guys doing?
Hired. We brought a full string section with us.
I look at all the lonely people. Do, do, do.
This is great. All right. Next. Get back. I gotta say this or my son will be mad. Sweet Loretta thought she was a cleaner. Sweet Loretta. Georgia was a man who thought he was a loner, but he knew he couldn't last. Georgia left his home in Tucson, Arizona, for some California grass. So get back to where you once belong. Get back to where you once belong. I'd like to say thank you on behalf of the group and ourselves, and I hope we pass the audition. Thank you very much. Billy McGuigan, Ryan McGuigan, Matthew McGuigan. Yesterday and Today is the name of our program. Thank you for having us.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.